now I'm going to add something to the Trill warm-up where we talked about motion through the arm, finessing the weight of the flute depending on which side, which hand is doing the trilling, doing the fast movement. But we're going to add a little exercise thinking about how we take our fingers off a key. And this is from Keith, my dear friend Keith Underwood. He calls this popping off. So I'm going to lift my fingers off the flute in a popping fashion so that it's relaxed, it's quick, but it's not tense. It's a release every time I lift off a key. So this is still a trill, but an uneven one where I'm thinking about springy release. And a crucial part of popping off is to flex this knuckle a bit. This one, that your finger can open a little bit rather than move higher up in the hand. Again, I think it's very relaxing. It's rapid, but it is a release, a relaxation for the hand. So here's popping off. I'm gonna come a little closer. Once more. That's E flat to E natural, D sharp to E natural, E flat to D. That's a good little pinky workout there. Again, relaxed, relaxed, relaxed. How about the other hand? A flat to G natural. Okay, so I was pulling away. I want to keep my hand near the tube of the flute. This is a bad habit of mine. How about two fingers? Doing this, not this. So I look forward to you experimenting with popping off and seeing if it wakes up your hands, gets you ready to practice more difficult things, and might solve some little technical issues you have. Let me know if you have questions or comments or an interesting experience with that. And next time I'm going to show you a little sort of warm-up melody based on these trilling and popping off exercises. Thanks.